Okay, so we're going to be doing a monoprint. So what you need is a piece of glass. This is your piece of glass. And what we've done is we've made a photostat. You can use a color photostat, which of course makes life easier. And it's easier to work on a slightly bigger one. This is an A3 size. There's three different types of way that you can do monoprint. So I'll show one at a time. Now, this is a bit of a crook having the image underneath, but, you know, it does make life a lot easier. So what we do is the first way of doing the monoprint, and obviously you need a roller, is I'm just going to paint the color that I want on it. So now, obviously, you can use either a hoxie or a nylon. It doesn't matter. The nylon will give you smooth and the hoxie is going to give you not smooth. So I'm going to start off by painting in... just painting in the image. Now, what you do is you see I'm not using any water with the paint. We're using acrylic paint here.
So it has to be thick.
It has to be nice and thick. You can thin it down. I'll show you a way later on when we thin it down as well. But in this case, I'm using it thick. If you use it thin, then you get a different kind of feel about it. These are on. So I'm just painting in what I see here. So that's what's nice. It's a nice crook to have the figure or the whatever image you want underneath. But one of the most important things about the monoprint is you need to do it quick because you don't want the paint to get dry. That's why we sometimes... get me some water.
Can you use oils?
You can use oils, and oils works very nicely because it stays wet long. I need your paper. So what we're going to do now is we're going to put the paper on top, and then you get the reverse image of what you've got. That doesn't matter. Okay, so there's my paper. You can use textured paper, or this is a very smooth one, but textured paper is actually nice. So what I'm doing, the trick is that you need to register. So I'm going to use the edge of the glass to be my registration, so that every single time I put it on, that it sits in the same place. So now you can take the roller and roll it.
So what paper? Any paper?
It would be better to use nice hot paper, but if you want to get away with, as long as it's a nice thick paper, like a 200 gram would be fine. So now if I take it off, there's the image. Can you see?
You want more paper?
Yeah, no, I'm gonna use the same image. So now you can underneath a cloth. So now you can remove some of, you can either remove the paint that you've already got there, or you can leave it on. So now I'm gonna start adding another color. So just for fun, I'm gonna just add a red, or let's just add a red for now. So now I'm gonna use it thinner so that you can see the difference. So now I'm making it thinner. So now I'm using a more watery kind of feel. Can you see? It's more watery, it's more runny. There we go. So this is like, it's going to show me the... the contours of what I've got there. So now this is where the registration comes in. So now I need to put it exactly in the same position as I've put it before. Now some people just use their hands or the back of a spoon. I just like the roller because it gives me even pressure everywhere. But you don't have. Now I'm starting to get an image, like other things happening here. So now I'm going to put a third color on. So I'm going to put some color at the back here. I'm going to just make it like a blue or something. So now I'm going to, okay, now this is a very translucent paint. So now here I'm going to be more like thickish now again. So this is only one technique. Okay? There's three different types of monoprints. But the nice thing is you get very quick results. Okay, so now I'm going to put the third one on. Let's hope this is dry. It might not be totally dry.
But does it matter if it's dry because it's a difference on the other side?
It would be better if it's dry because then you get you get different layers over each other. Can you see what's happening? Okay, so I'm just gonna wipe it off. And so while that's drying. So now I'm gonna put another layer of paint. Now I can also roll out paint on here and then draw inside of it. So let's say I've got light is in the body. So you can be very selective where you put your paints on. And that's why it's nice to have the the example of the whatever you want to paint underneath. I'm going to use this paint that I've sort of semi-wiped off now. Now I'm going to take away what I don't want. So I'm wiping. I'm wiping away where I don't want it. Okay. Can you see? So I don't want that to be a thing.
On the body.
Yeah, I don't want it on the body, so I'm just wiping it away. So this sort of wet. Now you can also, what's very interesting, you can go and you can create texture. So I can go with a cloth. Look there. Can you see I'm creating like a texture with the cloth? Now I put it back over. And even if it does misregister in a little bit, that's part of the whole
abstracting, yeah, impressionistic.
Yeah. Now the textured paper, which is actually made for, like this paper is very smooth, so it doesn't absorb wet very well. Can you see there's a little, look at that interesting shapes. Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah.
Can you see? If I can dry that fast. I'm almost drawing with the brush.
A little fly or anything, because that wouldn't... I mean,
it would be difficult because it's small. It would be difficult. Okay. Can you see it's getting interesting, eh? A lot of paint on here, and I'm going to mix different colors into the.
So you're doing the abstract now.
Yeah. And I'm going to use my roller now. So I need lots of color. And you can combine these different techniques. And now I'm putting the paper down first. Now I'm putting my image this way. Now with the back of a brush, I can either softly, now this is, I need to control the pressure I'm putting on it now. So now I'm actually drawing in. Okay, now if you look here, you can't see it so well now, so we'll do it with the next one. There's the image there. Can you see? Here's the image. Can you see there? So I'm going to put another color.
It's the reverse.
So now I'm going to add, I'm going to put a darker area here. Yeah, you can see there's the other one, this has got, that's what's nice about the texture. So now I need to put it back. So I now don't want to put much pressure on this now, because I only want the pressure where the figure is. So your registration here is, so now I'm making sure I'm only pressing here where the figure is. So now I'm going to use my fingers to just rub where I want the dark. So I'm making sure I'm not touching anywhere else. I'm only rubbing where the dark is. It's fun because it's a surprise every time you lift it up. Bang. Okay, there we go. Can you see? Starting to come out.
Yeah.
Okay, so now I want maybe to put a little bit more... think about put a little bit more light. Okay, so now thank you. So now again, this way. Put it down. Put my image down, register, make sure your registration is right. So now I'm just gonna again do the same thing. I'm just putting where I want the light. Glaze. Okay, so there you've got the, she does look pregnant, huh? Can you see? Okay. So now I'm gonna work on this one. So let's, this one we had the image underneath, eh? Yeah. Okay, so now I'm going to show you, so you don't have to dry that one now. I'm going to show you how to add now a glaze to this. So you can treat it now like a normal painting almost. So the nice thing is, if you have the reverse of this, it's easier to see. So yeah. I'm going to use a brush. So I want to say add a little bit of darkness to the side. So I'm going to use, so this must be dry. So I'm just going to crook a little bit and add a purple. So I'm just going to sort of bring out some of the, I'm just putting a glaze on it. Can you see? I'm actually glazing over the background. I'm going to use this paint that I've sort of semi-wiped off now. Now I'm going to take away what I don't want. So I'm wiping. Oh, Nick. I'm wiping away where I don't want it. Okay. Can you see? So I don't want that to be a thing. Yeah, I don't want it on the body. So I'm just wiping it away. So this sort of wet. Now you can also, what's very interesting, you can go and you can create texture. So I can go with a cloth. Look there. Can you see I'm creating like a texture with the cloth? Now I put it back over. And even if it does misregister in a little bit, that's part of the whole
abstract, yeah, impressionistic.
Yeah. Now the textured paper, which is actually made for, like this paper is very smooth, so it doesn't absorb wet very well. Can you see there's a little, look at that interesting shape. Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah.
Can you see? So I can dry that fast. So now I'm going to show you another way. So now what I want to do is I want to paint on, let me just see, okay, she needs a bit more dark, I think. So I'm going to make a purple. That's a nice color. It's interesting, eh? So I'm almost drawing with the brush. Can you see there?
I was going to say, do the outline dark now.
You can't do, with this sort of technique, you can't do small little things.
No. It has to be a big thing. Yeah. Thank you.
You can't do like little fly or anything, because that wouldn't... I mean,
it would be difficult because it's small. It would be difficult. Okay. Can you see it's getting interesting, eh?
But she does look pregnant now.
Yeah, it's because of the... Okay, now there's another way. We don't have another image like this, but I'm going to show you another thing that we can do. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna take this out here. This is now another way of doing it. Give me another piece of paper. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a lot of paint on here. This is a totally different way.
You're going to have to put the cloth down.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to put a lot of paint on here and I'm going to mix different colors into the...
So you're doing the abstract there.
Yeah. And I'm going to use my roller now. So I need lots of color. Yeah.
as you're going to make the whole
background.
Mm-hmm.
It is a quick way of doing it, eh?
And you can combine these different techniques. And now I'm putting I'm putting the paper down first. Now I'm putting my image this way. Now with the back of a brush, I can either softly, now this is, I need to control the pressure I'm putting on it now. So now, I'm actually drawing in. And this is kind of, it's a totally different technique than the previous one, but you can combine them. I'm just drawing sort of the outline. So this is why it's like to have an image that you, I mean, you can obviously work out of your head, but it just makes life much easier if you don't have to do that. So again, I have no idea really what's going to,
side.
So I can lift it up like this and then have a look. Can you see there's the image sitting there? So I can do different colors again over each other.
Oh, so then you have to keep on drawing, drawing it out.
Okay, now the only thing is I need to mark for myself where I put this paper. Give me a pencil something. Pencil? Okay, I just need to mark here where I've put this now. Okay, so I need to put this thing in the same position on the back of this paper. Okay, now if you look here, you can't see it so well now, so we'll do it with the next one. There's the image there. Can you see? Here's the image. Can you see there? So I'm going to put another color.
Reverse side.
It's the reverse, yeah. So now I'm going to put a darker area here.
So you keep that paint on there, you don't take it off?
You can take it off. I'm just being lazy now. You can see there's the other one. This has got, that's what's nice about the texture. So now I need to put it back. So I now don't want to put much pressure on this now, because I only want the pressure where the figure is. So your registration here is, so now I'm making sure I'm only pressing here where the figure is. So now I'm going to use my fingers to just rub where I want the dark. So I'm making sure I'm not touching anywhere else. I'm only rubbing where the dark is. There we go. So it's fun because it's a surprise every time you lift it up. Bang. Okay, there we go. Can you see? Starting to come out?
Yeah.
Okay, so now I want maybe to put a little bit more, let's think about, put a little bit more light. Okay, so now taking away again. And even this, where you've got this loose like paint where it is now, that you can all use to do prints. You can do like, you can work on like 4 or 5 different prints at the same time, which is fun.
Yeah.
It's very messy though. It's the only negative side of it.
Yeah, it's the fun side too.
Oh, is it the fun side?
Yeah.
Okay, so now I want to bring some light in. So now I'm going to put that's fine. So I'm going to sort of guess where the light is sort of sitting here somewhere.
It does look awesome.
And then we'll work on that one a little bit more just now, okay? Thank you. So now, again, this way. Put it down. Put my image down, register, make sure your registration is right. So now I'm just gonna, again, do the same thing. I'm just putting where I want the light. See, this is not very clear where the hand is, so she might, yeah, she might look pregnant, yeah. Okay. And I'll show you now how to use also a glaze. Okay, so there you got the, she does look pregnant, huh? Can you see? Okay. So now I'm gonna work on this one. So let's, this one we had the image underneath, eh? Yeah. Okay, so now I'm gonna show you, so you don't have to dry that one now. I'm gonna show you how to add now a glaze to this. So you can treat it now like a normal painting almost. So the nice thing is if you have the reverse of this, it's easier to see. So yeah. I'm gonna use a brush. So I want to say add a little bit of darkness to the side. So I'm going to use, so this should, this must be dry. So I'm just going to crook a little bit and add a purple. So I'm just going to sort of bring out some of the, I'm just putting a glaze on it. Can you see? I'm actually glazing over the background. Can you see? So it's a, you know, no glaze, it's just a thin layer of paint. And you can glaze and then over that you can print again. So I'm just sort of making it a little bit more interesting for myself. So there she's at her darks and she's got her shoulders somewhere. And I like the light here, so I'm going to actually bring it out. So obviously I can't see the image, so I don't have much control. I'm imagining. And you can, I mean, there's no limitation as to how far you need to take it. You can keep on going until you...
You can have, make it thick.
Now I'm using very thin paint.
No, I mean, you can keep on going until it's thick.
Oh, yeah, you can. It's, there's no limitation. And then over this, I can print again. Looks like she's holding something in her hand.
Oh, yeah, there is, because it's a piece of fabric, see?
Oh, okay. So I like this very bright there, so I want to reinforce that. Okay, so now... Can you see? Looks nice, eh? So, like, can you see this bright yellows here? So you can either now reprint that, or you can glaze it. I would just glaze it in, it's so much easier. Because you're crooking a bit, but, you know, so what? So that's got a nice bright yellow. And then I'm going to print over it just now again. And I'm going to add some more color to that one as well. So now I'm just, it's a thin glaze. The trick is that you just have to print over the glaze again. So the glaze is just there to help what you've already got. Can you see? I'm just brightening up certain areas. So technically you're not allowed, a monoprint is not allowed to have a glaze or any paint on it. You're supposed to have printed everything technically, but you know, who says we can't break the rules?
So So who does monoprints? A lot of artists
does monoprints. It's a very quick and easy way to do to get. I love this watery effect here. I'm gonna try and work it a bit more just now. So I'm just brightening the yellow prints that I've done. Can you see the difference it's making? It gives a lovely feel. Yeah. Okay, so let that one dry now, so you've got a nice feel. So now we're going back to this one.
Can you hold it up?
Love it.
Yeah, can you see? It's an easy... Mm. Okay, now this one, nice. We can also work with glazes on this one. So let's start off by... I'm just going to give this like an orangey already glaze. Where the paper doesn't pick up the texture. Yeah, can you see that? But look at the nice textures you're getting. Now, as you can also draw in this, and it will give you another. So you can go in this. You can do whatever you want here.
And then I suppose you could also leave out the image totally and just do the outside.
You can do that, for sure. I'm now removing some of the paint. Again, I don't know what's going to come out.
That's unique, never to be repeated
again. Yeah, you can never, totally true. You can never do the same thing twice.
You have to do it, you have to have glass.
Yeah. Look, you can work on, you can have four of the same image, you can repeat four, five, or ten of the same images, but each one will be uniquely different. Look there. Does that look cool?
To think of good reasons to keep on.